the cost of debt is the return investors expect to receive for assets with the same level of risk as the firm's debt. Recall that the riskiness of equity depends on the capital structure of the firm. The same is true for debt. The higher the debt level of a firm, the more likely it is that this firm will be unable to pay it in full. For this reason, the riskiness of a firm's debt increases with the amount of debt. In this course, we have developed a measure of the risk of equity, that is beta, and we studied a relation to figure out the expected return based on this risk, the CAPM. For debt, we will do something similar but more straightforward. Rating agencies like Moody's or S&P study firms and assign to them a debt rating. For example, a rating of AAA means that the debt is very safe. A rating of AA means slightly more risky debt. A debt rating of C means debt that is very risky. The table here shows the different rating categories used by major rating agencies. We know that Walmart's rating is AA. This tells us that Walmart's debt is relatively safe. Hence, the return investors should expect should be low. Now, once we know the risk, in this case AA, how do we find the appropriate return? Typically, we look at other firms with the same debt rating and use the return investors are demanding for their debt. Debt rating agencies also publish tables with the return on debt as a function of the debt rating. There is one more issue to tackle here. As opposed to equity, debt comes with different maturities. The rate of return offered on debt of different maturities is not the same. Which one should we use? It is common practice to use a 10-year maturity as an approximation to the average maturity of a firm's debt. Looking at the rate of return offered by similar debt, I estimate the cost of debt at 2.99%. We can now add this value to our table of weighted average cost of capital inputs.